Hi, good morning, John here. This is a bit of an impromptu video, actually, which was prompted by a set of circumstances which I thought I'd share with you, just in case you fall upon the same sort of scenario which caught me and Jilly out this morning. We were planning to go to Yorkshire today, and it's a bit of a long trip, so we wanted to charge the car the night before. So I set the Tesla to charge on the Zappy, and I set up the scheduled charging in the Tesla, and I'll just show you that. So down here, scheduled charging, a bit bright, start charging at. So I put start charging at and the time, and didn't put in the departure time, so I just did it like that. So start charging at 1 o'clock. Roll on to this morning, should have charged overnight, and it didn't, which means we didn't have enough charge to get up to Yorkshire. So I thought, well, no problem. I'll quickly charge it a bit this morning. So went to the My Energy app, just clicked the Zappy on to fast charge, and that started charging while we were getting ready and decided that we'll head off and drop into a supercharger. Charge there and then just head up to Yorkshire. So the Zappy was charging this morning. It put about 3.6 kilowatts in, so not a great amount, but enough just to add a bit of charge before we set off towards the supercharger at Northampton at Grange Park. We arrived there, nobody there, six chargers, all empty, and plugged the car in. And nothing. It recognised the cable. It said charging equipment not ready. See equipment instructions to start charging, which was very rare because I hadn't seen that before. So, perhaps that charger is faulty. So we disconnected that one and moved across to another charger in the same location. It's connected it up, exactly the same scenario. Well, this is strange, two not working. So I tried a third one, third time lucky. Same scenario again. At Grange Park, there's also a sign which says you have to check in with reception before charging. So I thought, okay, well, I wonder if that's something to do with it. And they have automatic number plate recognition there because it's a hotel car park and on an industrial estate. So I guess they get a lot of people just parking there and going to work for the day. But well, I'll go in and register. So I did that. Registered the APNR, you have to go in there and plug in your vehicle registration number and sort of sign in and register so you don't get nabbed by the APNR. And I thought, well, surely those two can't be connected, i.e. you have to register before you can charge, because you know, that just didn't seem very logical. But the only thing I could think of at the time, why wouldn't it charge? So we thought, OK, well, we're not getting anywhere here. Three chargers tried and none of them work. We'll drop to Newport Pagnell, because I know we've charged the car there before and we know it works. And it's only sort of 9 miles away. So onto the M1, tootle along there, arrive at Newport Pagnell, plugged it in, nothing. Wouldn't charge at all. Exactly the same message. Charging equipment not ready. See instructions to start charging. So, you know, I was flummoxed, really. So I thought, and I'll phone Tesla support. How do I phone Tesla support? Looked on the charger. There's a label there which says, for support, phone this number, and it's just blank. And that's the same on all the chargers there. Whereas I did note on the ones at Grange Park, does actually have a number on there. Well, I didn't know what the number was because I didn't record it, make a record of it. So I thought, I'll go onto the internet, try and find the phone number. And I did find the support phone number in the end and phoned it. Before that, a bit of useful information as well. I've learned a lot today. The little button in the car, the SOS button, does actually ring the emergency services. I thought it was just a general Tesla number that then routed you according to what your problem was. But no, I pressed it and it said dialing emergency services, and I got through to the emergency services and the lady said, which service do you need, fire, ambulance or police? To which then I had to own up to being a twat and said, yeah, sorry, my error. I thought this went through to Tesla's service team first before it went through to you guys. So I have no emergency, so I'll just drop the call. Which she did, so that was fine. The SOS in the car, if you have that button up on the head console there, does actually dial the emergency services. So back to Newport Pagnell. Tried the phone number that we found from the internet, and that takes you through to like Roadside Assistance, which you can dial if you have a puncture or a crash or something like that, you've broken down. But it didn't have anything around superchargers, so hung up on that. And there was a queue waiting as well.
Our customer support specialists are currently assisting other owners. Please continue to hold, and your call will be answered in the order it was received.
So we decided, tell you what, we've got 20 miles of range in the car, and we were on 9% state of charge. We can get home from there, and we'll worry about it when we get home. So we tiddled home as slowly as possible without causing inconvenience to our road users, took the back roads and what have you. And we arrived home with 5% state of charge. And I plugged the car into the Zappy, plugged it in straight away, and it started charging. So, and then it dawned on me that when I looked at the charging options, I still had that scheduled charging plugged in. And I wondered if that was the problem at the superchargers, why it wouldn't actually start charging. So you join me. I've now charged the car at home. It's got 28% charge in it. And I am going, I've still got, let's turn you around. So as you can see here, we've still got scheduled charge in. So I'm going to knock that off. I should do up there. And I think if we now go to a supercharger, it will charge. So that's my theory that it is. I'm about to go and test it out. So I shall join you at the supercharger. All right, see you in a bit. Bye. Hi, so I have turned up at the Newport Pagnell supercharger. This is my second supercharger stop. I went to the one at Grange Park in Northampton, plugged in, nothing. Made sure that the scheduled charge wasn't scheduled in. There was no data in there, so it was set to off and plugged in and nothing. So I thought, that's not good. Not what I expected. So I've come to the Newport Pagnell one and try there. So just going to show you the screen. 17% charge. We've got scheduled charging is off, as you can see there. So that shouldn't be a problem. So I'm going to open the charge port. Charge port is open. So follow me. Same thing again. It says are ready to charge. Now we just make sure that is definitely off. Set limit. And nothing. Not charging at all at a supercharger. Which was interesting because on the way to Grange Park, it confirmed that it was preconditioning the battery ready for supercharging. So you'd think it was accepting it, but for some reason it's not actually charging at all, doing nothing. So that's interesting. So phone call me thinks.
Thank you for calling Tesla. If you are in an emergency breakdown situation, including flat tires and lockouts, press 1. If you have been in an accident, please hang up and call your insurance, and if needed, emergency services. This is a dedicated emergency roadside line, and non-emergency roadside calls will be redirected.
customer support, you're speaking with Jordan. How may I help?
Yes, hi. I'm stuck at a supercharger and I'm unable to charge for some reason. I'm not sure why. Are you able to look at your end to see why?
Yeah. Can you give me the last six digits of your VIN?
Yes, I can. The last, how many?
Last six, please.
Last six. It's 502652.
Thank you. Do you get any errors on the screen, or...?
No, I've tried a couple of superchargers. It says the charging equipment not ready. See equipment instructions to start charging. So I've never seen that before.
Okay.
I've rebooted the car, a full reboot, and it doesn't make any difference. And I've tried actually two different supercharger locations, so I'm guessing it's car related rather than supercharging network.
So you say you tried two different locations?
Yes, yeah, I've tried Grange Park in Northampton. I'm currently at Newport Pagnell supercharger.
How is it called?
Sorry, say again.
The one that you are at right now?
Yeah, I'm at Newport Pagnell, Milton Keynes.
Milton Keynes.
Well, it's under Newport Pagnell supercharger.
Oh, okay. And you say you rebooted the car. Do you mean the reboot with the two scroll buttons?
No, the full reboot with the brake pedal held down as well.
But pressing the two scroll buttons?
Yeah, two scroll buttons and the brake.
Yeah, okay. So is the cable currently connected?
Yes, it is.
Can you take it out and go back inside the car?
Yeah, no problem. Hang on a second. Well, the outcome of the service call. I didn't keep you on the phone for ages because it needed a full reboot and they were looking at it remotely. The outcome is they can't see anything wrong with the car and they can't see anything wrong with the supercharger, so they're not really sure what the problem is. At the end of the day, I can't supercharge for some reason. So I shall book a service call. The chap was very helpful on the phone, but couldn't really diagnose the problem remotely. So he said the best thing is to book a service call and they come out and see what it is. So yeah, there you go. Gonna head home. I've got 17%, so I shall get home okay. I can plug it in at home and it will charge at home. So I don't really know what the problem is. Anyway, future update. I shall chat to you later. All right, take care. Bye. Oh, like and subscribe. Certainly like, certainly comment, certainly subscribe as well. Marvellous. All right, take care. Bye.